Hi everybody, today I'm going to do a video about how I ended up with complex cerebral pain syndrome. So basically we need to rewind all the way back to 2010. And I suppose it all started when my son was born. I went into premature labour and he was born asleep, which just shattered my world, and I don't think it's ever really rebuilt properly after that. Emotional pain is the worst, I think, and you don't ever get over it, you just make room for it. Caden was born asleep, and afterwards, for like 10 months after, I was hemorrhaging, in a lot of pain, and I kept going to the doctors, going to A&E, and nothing seemed to be, you know, getting done. I was told it was a heavy period, which it was not a heavy period. Anyway, after 10 months, I eventually had a scan. And it's shown that I had a AVM, a uterine AVM, which is an intravenous malformation, and is basically like a blood vessel mass, and it covered the entirety of my womb, and I needed to have a hysterectomy. And I was only 19 at the time, so this just, it absolutely floored me. And I think because Caden was stillborn, you know, and I got no other biological children, that it was harder. It was a big blow. My consultant gynecologist, he said, you know, it's a hysterectomy, or you can try this embolism. He said, but, you know, you over 90% you will hemorrhage and it will be fatal within the next few months. So, yeah, it wasn't really a choice. It was die or have this hysterectomy. So I had the hysterectomy, and I don't think I ever really, I knew I was having a hysterectomy, but I didn't understand, I didn't comprehend what that meant. You know, obviously I knew that meant that I wouldn't be able to get pregnant, but I don't really think that ever really sunk in. I suppose I was in a bit of denial, and there's still some aspect of it. I mean, I forget sometimes. And, you know, looking at babies, and I'm like, oh, I want one. And I'm like, remember, you can't. And this is nearly 10 years on. It's 9 years since I had my hysterectomy. 8 years. I did it in 2011. Caden died, and then the hysterectomy was 10 months after, and I thought, God, well, you know, I've got through this hysterectomy, which was extremely high risk because of my heart. So, you know, I've got through this. You know, God gives you these things, you know, to, if I don't believe in God, but you still thought, you know, God's just testing you, you know, good things will come. You know, you've got through all the bad. And then I ended up, I thought it was pain from surgery for a start, and it just didn't ever go away. And it got worse and worse and worse. I have CPS in my stomach and my back, down my thighs, and it's coming down this left arm here as well. But it didn't start that way. It just started off with a section where I'd had my hysterectomy, you know, that a long section, it was tingling and the burning. And I thought maybe it's infection. No. Anyway, it never went away. And it just got worse. And I don't know why, but I kind of think of it as this reminder of pain, the physical pains there. Maybe helps mask the emotional. If I can't speak today, I've had too much morphine. May it helps mask the emotional pain a bit. I don't know. I went off topic. But I would rather have the CPS than hysterectomies. And had my son here, and it would all have been worth it. Sorry. But no, I think it, you know. But now it's like a, you know, why? Whereas if I had ended up this way a bit, Caden might still won, then it would have all have been worth it. And I didn't want to cry. But that's the thing. You know, Caden was born in 2010, we're now in 2019. And it's no easier. You just adapt to going forward, and then you have days where it knocks you off your feet. And then obviously living with pain from the CPS is hard mentally. You start, you know, you start mushing days away. And a lot of days just merge into one, especially when you have no sleep. It's terrible. I've gone totally off topic. I've gone not working. So yeah, my mind has boggled now. But yeah, anyway, after I had my hysterectomy, I struggled with this pain, obviously, and it weren't going away. And after, I think it was 4 years, I finally got the complex regional pain syndrome diagnosis.